Good evening, brothers and sisters, or good morning, or good lunch, whatever time of day it is. I'm glad that you're watching this video. I'm glad I can be of service to someone, but thank you for watching, in all sincerity. I put a lot of time and energy in hopes that some good will come out of this. I don't know how often I'll be able to do it, so when I do find the time, I try to squeeze it in the best as I could without letting too much of my personal life wither. So you know, I'm going through things right now. At least the feeling of about the horrible, dreadful feeling that one gets when one anticipates becoming homeless and the uncertainty. But anyway, this book today is about self-loathing. I got stuck in this trap myself for a number of years, and sometimes I still find myself doing it. So once again, I'm reading this article for my brothers and as well for myself. As you can see, self-work and self-improvement is a big yes. Continue to do so. Okay, now this self-loathing article was written by Miss Jo Barrington, and here goes everything and nothing at the same time. Self-loathing. Self-loathing is that underlying feeling that we're just not good enough. Not good enough, not good at this, not good at that, not good at or for much of anything. It can be subtle. We may habitually compare ourselves to others, for instance, constantly finding fault with ourselves and putting ourselves down with no real awareness that there is anything amiss. Or we may listen intently to our critical inner voice while it scolds and berates us, telling us how embarrassing, stupid, and insensitive we are, refusing to challenge it even while we suffer from it. Or we may listen intently to our critical inner voice while it scolds and berates us, telling us how embarrassing, stupid, or insensitive we are, refusing to challenge it even while we suffer from it. We may try to suppress this feeling of inadequacy by behaving as though we are superior to a more intelligent, clever, intuitive, or attractive. It's as though we have to prove that we are the absolute best in order to avoid a torrent of internal abuse waiting to pounce the moment we show any fallibility. However, it is manifest self-loathing process indicative of a divide that exists within all people between our healthy and realistic point of view towards ourselves and the internal enemy or inner cult that fights tooth and nail to assert its inimical way looking at ourselves and the life we are living. The causes of self-loathing. According to Dr. Lisa Fires and Joyce Catlett in the book Conquer Your Critical Inner Voice, the causes of self-loathing lie in the past when as children we were trying to cope with our lives in the best way possible. They go on to further explain. The nature and degree of this division within ourselves depends on the parenting we received and the early environment we experienced. Parents, like all of us, have mixed feelings towards themselves. They have things they like about themselves and they have self-critical thoughts and feelings. The same negative feelings that parents have towards themselves are unfortunately often directed towards their children as well. In addition, if a parent has unresolved feelings from either trauma or loss in his or her past, this will impact his or her reaction to his or her children. Because of their acute sensitivity to pain and negative circumstances, children of all ages pay particular attention to and are more affected by even small incidences of parental anger. They may experience a parent's anger, whether acted out or not, as being life-threatening. Under extreme circumstances, they may be accurate in their perceptions. In any case, children in stressful situations often feel threatened at the core of their being and are frightened for their lives. During times of stress, when children are afraid, they stop identifying with themselves as the helpless child and instead identify with the verbally or physically punishing parent. The parent is assimilated or taken in as he or she is at that moment when he or she is at his or her worst, not as he or she is every day. The child tends to take on the anger, feelings, fear, and self-hatred. In fact, the whole complex of emotions the parent is experiencing at the same time. So due to very human, hence very fallible upbringings, we have all been subjected to situations and times in which we were made to feel like we were somehow bad, inadequate, desperately needing to prove otherwise. Robert Firestone's most recent work, Overcoming the Destructive Inner Voice, True Stories of Therapy and Transformation, is a book of short stories in which he relates various therapeutic experiences from his career. Self-loathing seems to be an underlying theme among many of these very personal narratives, particularly the chapter entitled Uninvited, in which Dr. Firestone is a student in psychology at Denver University when an old friend drops in, almost catatonic, seeking help. In fierce, funny, and sharply intelligent prose, Dr. Firestone describes this young man's struggle set against the rich backdrop of his own personal circumstances. self-loathing, the critical inner voice or internal code, seems as though it may just be your conscious. For example, it may tell you about things you are doing that are not in your interest, just like your conscious does. But this process is diametrically opposed to your self-interest. Whereas your conscious will tell you not to have that one drink too many, this process first lures you into taking that drink and then attacks you viciously for having taken it. Your conscious may nag at you to revisit a conversation which you may have not been kind, for instance, and from there you can think about it and decide what you would like to do. The internal enemy either justifies you having been rude by attacking the other person, he deserved it, he is such a jerk, or berates you furiously for your part, you're always so touchy, mean, no wonder no one likes you. How to overcome self-loathing. No matter what circumstances you find yourself in, a nasty point of view towards yourself is never warranted. It is never in your self-interest. The proper viewpoint towards yourself should be one of friendship. Think about yourself and treat yourself as you would a close friend, respectfully and with affection, with understanding and empathy, and maybe most importantly, with a sense of easiness and humor. You are very powerful in your own right, free to choose any point of view or course of action available to you. Any inner voice that defies you, either tearing you down, you're such an idiot, or building you up, you're the smartest one in the school, is attempting to take away your power and freedom. You must be your own advocate, taking your own side in your life. There are many avenues through which to address the issue of self-loathing. First, just by becoming aware that a division exists within us allows for a more rational, reasonable assessment of events in our daily lives. Once we have identified this process as being different from honest self-reflection, we are then able to think more objectively about ourselves and the various situations we encounter. Further, there are a variety of therapy techniques geared towards helping people to address the negative ways of viewing themselves that lead to self-loathing. Challenging the tendency towards self-loathing is one of the most valuable. As we extricate ourselves from this inimical process, we become freer to experience ourselves and the lives we are living from a kindly and empowered perspective. There you go, guys. This is again from our psychologist, author Joe Barry, Self-Loathing, Contrast of Self-Love. So that's why I felt it was important that we made a short video about it. Okay, thank you. Please like and subscribe. God bless. Bigs.